There was this husband who would always criticize his wife.
If you worked out, they'd fit.
Hey, what's up guys? Dubz Hill in the building. How you been? So today's video is about a channel, a guy that I found recently, and I just I couldn't help myself but make this video. Basically, it's on this guy, Dhar Mann. Now, for those of you that aren't aware who he is, Dhar Mann basically creates these motivational videos. It's actually quite decent content, in a sense that he does these sketches and these little stories with the same actors in each one. They're obviously his preferred actors and actresses, but he makes these motivational videos basically creating these stories, like guy leaves his wife for another woman and guess what happens next, and all that sort of jazz. So some of the acting is comical. I get what he's doing, and he's got a massive following, so big up to yourself, mate. Apologies for this video. It's purely for entertainment factors, all right? As many of us do. But without further ado, let's roll.
There was this husband who would always criticize his wife.
If you worked out, they'd fit.
I mean, who fucking wrote this? That's savage off the bat. Absolute savage. If you worked out, they'd fit.
You know, those stretch marks look really bad.
Fuck. I mean, can you get away with this shit? Those stretch marks look really bad. Yeah, so do your fucking forehead, bro. Do you know what I mean? Jesus, man, you know, fucking. I take it this wasn't filmed on Valentine's Day, February the 14th. That's absolute savage.
Are you really gonna wear that?
You know, in my opinion, by the looks of the video so far, the wife, she obviously, excuse the noise, the dog's having his dinner. The wife, obviously, she can't talk, or, I mean, I know, and probably most of you guys out there, I wouldn't fucking dare say anything even remotely savage to my missus, because yeah, a clout round the head would be the least of my worries, trust me. Yeah, this is just next level savage business, man. Next level savage. I mean, I love the way he's just sat there. He is just sat there, you know, just throughout the whole thing. Hey mate, how you doing? No, I can't come out at the moment, mate. I'm just fucking slating the wife. I'll catch you in a bit, yeah? All right, cheers, bye, bye.
Are you really gonna wear that?
Are you really gonna wear that? I mean, come on, man. Fuck it. You know, I'm up for, you know, doing these like sketches and stuff to try and send some message at the end, but Jesus, man, you know, when you sat down and writ this script, was one of the criteria, I'm gonna fucking break this girl throughout the whole filming scenario. I mean, it's almost unbearable to watch, you know? Unbearable. I almost wanna just get on the film set and just give that guy a clap.
Have you thought this through?
Yeah, man, that's what I was doing on the bed, you know, last week, you know, when I was ripping the shit out of you, that's what I was doing. I was thinking this whole thing through, you know, and yeah, and then I packed my case and so here we are.
What about her?
Papa, please, please don't go.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, you know, if you were a better daughter, then maybe I'd stay and, you know, you're shit at tap dancing, you can't read properly, you can't spell your name, so, you know, what do you want me to say? What do you want me to say?
I've met someone else.
I knew it. What about us?
I've met someone else and she's had no kids. She's got no stretch marks. Her clothes fit. You know, it's a fucking no-brainer, love. You know, don't put me in this position.
I realized that I needed to start living for myself.
You can't just go. You can't do this.
I can. He was already out the door. He was already out the fucking door when you said that. He was already gone, man. Bags packed, out the door.
The husband ends up leaving his wife for a younger woman. The wife is devastated and spends all of her days crying. The husband starts partying and having a really good time with his new girl. He drank and partied and drank some more.
Where was the party, dude? There's no fucker there but you. Do you know what I mean? Where was you partying? It's fucking, you're fucking in an empty bar. Or maybe it's a lock-in or something, I don't know. But yeah, you know, he was having a great time and partying and drinking and partying, having a great time with his new girl.
Meanwhile, his wife slowly got over the breakup and realized it was time to start prioritizing herself.
Yeah, that's it. The husband leaves. Now I'm gonna hit the gym, boy. Fuck you, bro. Fuck you. Look at me doing squats. Do you know what I mean? Doing my makeup. My daughter's at tap dancing classes now, trying to get better at tap dancing. Fuck off.
A lot of time passed until one day he happened to run into her.
Well, he's running into something. Do you know what I mean? Pissed up. Walking around with your hand over your eyes, you're gonna run into all sorts, bro. All sorts.
Hey, Rachel.
Hey. Where is your new girl?
She left me. For a rich guy.
She left you for a rich guy. Fuck you, bro. Got it.
Well, I'm sorry.
Well, I was thinking. Maybe we can try this again.
I don't think it's a good idea. You see,
the reason I was overweight was because I never made time for myself. I was always so busy taking care of everyone else. And the reason I had stretch marks was from when I gave birth to our baby girl. And the reason I dressed so plain was to save money so you and our daughter could dress well.
See, you ungrateful fuck. You ungrateful twat. Everything she did for you. For you, motherfucker. And now you're on your own, and now you're lonely. I hope you rot in that gutter with your fucking whiskey. Fucking prick. Karma, bitch. Karma. Ha!
Everything I did it for our family. And when you left, I realized I had to start living for us. Goodbye.
Rachel. Rachel.
Fancy a whiskey? I got Jack.
When two people first meet, things can be really new and exciting. It's all we can think about. Every text and every date creates goosebumps all over our bodies.
I love the way this guy talks. When two people meet, it's all great and there's goosebumps all over our bodies. You know, I love the passion. I think he writes and films and produces all these stories himself. So, you know, fair play to the guy. Do you know what I mean? I see, you know, he's doing some good and getting the message across. And obviously people like his shit. I just find the whole scenarios, you know, just so cliche. But big up to the Dhar Mann. No offense, bro. Keep doing what you're doing.
But over time, that excitement starts to wear off. That shiny new relationship begins to lose its shine. And we can't help but think, is there someone better out there? The important part to remember is that not everything that glitters is always going to be gold.
Wasn't that a Prince song?
And whatever the problems are right now, doesn't mean they'll magically go away with someone else. There will always be plenty of options. But love is not about what you can get. It's about appreciating what you already have. If you're always looking for the next best thing, then you'll never see what's right in front of you.
What a beautiful message. No, on a serious note, take it seriously because, yeah, he is right what he says. So anyway, on that note, I'm going to leave you there. Thumbs up if you liked it. Thumbs down if you didn't. And don't forget, hit the big red subscribe button down the bottom. And ring that bell. Make sure you ring the bell. And I'll be back soon. I'm Dubz Hill. Real talk. Take care.